Okay. Yeah. No, I see what you're saying, but then how come it is that we're always meeting in private? No, I won't get mad. Go ahead, tell me. But why should you be bothered what people have to say about me? What matters is that we're together, nothing else. Yeah, it's stupid to say that, but it's okay, it doesn't matter. What does matter is that we are together, you and I. That's all that matters. Yeah, you need to get that. Yeah. And how's that? Okay. Alright. Okay, I think I'll see you tomorrow then. Yes. Alright. Good night. Bye-bye.
Hello? Hi. I'm on my way to the gym. How come you called now? I thought you'd be at work. Not that I mind, but... No, I just couldn't stay. I wanted to leave and I left. Evening? But wasn't it supposed to be at night? Okay. Alright, that's cool. Okay, bye.
Hi.
Hi. I'm so glad you're here.
Me too. So, how was your day?
The day was the same. I got up, then work. Then I just wanted to leave work. You know how it's always been.
I know. Why does your hair look shabbier than usual?
I have to get a haircut.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
I'll leave that for some other week. You know, I don't tell you this enough. Tell you how grateful I am that you're here with me. at the end of each day, every day. It's the only time I actually feel like breathing. I still remember the first time we spoke.
It's almost been 3 years.
Really? Has it been that long?
Yeah.
I can't even remember that now. All I know is that things have definitely changed. Especially since you've come into my life. I can recall so many times when I had nobody. And now I can always count on you to be there for me. I feel like I can always come back home to you. The staleness of the redundant things that we do in our everyday lives is just being evaporated with every single moment I spend with you. That's how I really feel. I'm sorry, you know how I ramble when I'm too tired.
I know, and I listen to you very patiently every single time. But why are you telling me all of this now?
Because I was reading this article in the morning about this guy who just killed himself in his apartment last night. The police, on investigating, found that he had no close relatives, no friends. He just had a regular desk job, a mechanical and boring life. Such a lonely life that I think the isolation just made him finally give up, and he decided to end everything. It's funny, but the more I kept reading about it, the more it reminded me of myself before I met you, 3 years ago, like you said. I was going through something very similar. I had no one, and I still have this very unproductive job. But the only difference is that I have you. I wish he had somebody in his life that he could come back to.